Hi friends, welcome to Sada Learning Hub. You are with me, Sadashiv Rao. In this video, we are going to learn native SQL. What is the native SQL and how to perform non-select operation on the native SQL? See guys, before going to discussion native SQL, non-select operation, I'm going to discuss about first, why native SQL comes into the picture and what is the native SQL and all those things. See here, in the Hibernate, we have to support to do the code operations on a single object at a time or multiple objects at a time. If you want to do the operations on a single object, we are going to use save, update, load, different methods are available. We want to do perform the operation on a single object. And if you want to perform operation on the multiple objects, we are going to use the criteria API. For example, if you want to do operation on a single object, we are going to use save, update, load, get. These are the different methods we are going to use to do operation on a single object. If you want to perform operation on the multiple objects at a time, we are going to use any one of these techniques, SQL or criteria API or native SQL. Now, in this video, I am going to discuss about native SQL. See, what is the native SQL first? Native SQL is used to executing a direct SQL queries from an application to a database. Now, it is going to execute a direct SQL. There is no conversion. It is a direct SQL. Whatever the query is executing on the database, the same query we are going to executing by using the Hibernate. We can perform the both select and non-select operation by using the native SQL. It supports the both select and non-select operations. This native SQL is mostly used when an existing JDBC application is migrating into the Hibernate applications. It is mostly used to migrating the JDBC application into Hibernate applications. The drawback of the native SQL is database dependent. The native SQL is the database dependent. It is a database dependent language. Native SQL is the database dependent. If we want to run the native SQL query, then we need to get the reference of SQL query interface. After getting the SQL query interface, we are going to execute the queries. To obtain the reference of SQL query, we need to call the create SQL query method in the session interface. We need to call create SQL query method in the session interface. If you see, this is the syntax to create a native SQL queries. See, I'm creating an SQL query reference by calling create SQL query interface of session object. Now here I am passing my native SQL query. Whatever the query is there, I am passing it here. This is the create method. It is returning the SQL query interface. Now, next I am going to discuss about how to perform non-select operation by using native SQL. Up to now, we discussed about how to do what is the native SQL and next, what is the native SQL and what are their uses, and now I'm going to discuss about non-select operation by using the native SQL. How to do the non-select operation by using native SQL. To run the non-select operation, to call the execute update method. If you want to run the non-select operation on the native SQL, we are going to use execute update method. The execute update method, it is executing the non-select operations. If any runtime values are required for the query, then we call the set parameters. If you want to set the parameters at runtime, or if you want to set the parameters dynamically, we are going to use set parameters to set your dynamic values. See here, I'm going to create a SQL query reference by calling the create SQL query method. By calling the create SQL query method. Now here I'm giving a query called update employee set salary where employee number is equal to something. Now here I am passing the query parameters. I am passing the question mark set here. Now I am passing these question mark dynamically while running my program. How I am setting these question mark? By calling the set parameters. The set parameters, it is going to set the question mark set here. Now this is the 0 is the first question mark, one is the second question mark. Now if you want to set the values dynamically at the runtime, we are going to use set parameters to set the parameters. After that, I'm beginning the transaction. This is the mandatory for the non-select operations. Definitely we need to begin the transaction. Finally, I'm calling the query.executeUpdate method. The executeUpdate method, it is going to execute our non-select native SQL. Finally, I'm committing my transaction. See, the non-select operation is called by executeUpdate method. To run the non-select operations, we need to call the executeUpdate method. If you want to set the parameters dynamically, we need to call the setParameters methods. After creating the SQL query reference, we need to set the parameters dynamically if you want. Next, I'm going to discuss about a simple example on this native SQL non-select operations. This is my project name. This is my Maven project. This is the Maven project. I'm going to explain how it is. See, there is a two resource files. The first one is hibernate.cfg.xml. In this configuration file, there is a connection properties and a Hibernate properties and a mapping location files. And coming here, this is the employee.hbm.xml. This is the mapping file. It is going to use to map your POJO class object to database. Next, I'm going to create a Java classes, two Java classes. The first one is employee.java. This is my POJO class. And the second one is native SQL non-select client. Now I'm using this program to I'm executing my non-select native SQL queries. I will show you an example practically how it is looks. See, I'm going to show you this is the non-SQL select. It is completed in my previous video. Now these are all projects are available in GitHub. Now I'm going to paste my GitHub link into video description. Just go through my video description and get the link. See, this is my pom.xml of this project. This is the Maven project. Now I'm configuring my dependency set here. This is my dependency. Now org.hibernate. And this is my another dependency, Oracle dependency. Now these two are my dependencies are required to my project. No need to download jars and all those things. Whenever you are saving, automatically it will be added into your class path. Coming to the resource files, I'm created two resource files. The first one is hibernate.cfg.xml. Now in this hibernate.cfg.xml contains connection properties. These are all connection properties. And coming here, these are all the Hibernate properties. And this is my mapping location, mapping resource location, where it is. This is about hibernate.cfg.xml. And coming to employee.hbm.xml, this is the mapping file. I'm going to map with my POJO class and the database, POJO class to database. This is my POJO class name, and this is my table name. And coming here, this is my primary key column. This is my POJO class property name, and coming here, this is my column name in the table. These three are the non-primary key columns. Now I'm going to show you the Java files. See, this is my Java file, employee.java. In this Java file, I'm going to declare my properties, employee ID, employee name, and employee salary, and department number. Now I'm generating the setters and getters for this. And the constructors of this class. After that, I'm going to use to update records by using this program. First I created the configuration object. I'm loading my configuration file hibernate.cfz.xml. Next, I'm creating a session factory bean object by calling build session factory. I'm passing the build session factory one parameter that is called service registry. Now this is the syntax from Hibernate 4 onwards. After that, I'm creating a session object. Now see, I'm creating a SQL query for the non-select operation. This is for non-select operation. Now I'm creating the SQL query. It is giving the reference of SQL query. Now here I'm updating employee. Set employee sal is equal to where employee ID is equal to something. Now I'm setting the salary of a particular employee based on this number. Now query dot set parameters. The first parameter I'm setting the salary. Now I'm setting the salary is 999. And the second parameter I'm setting the employee ID is 1. Who is the employee ID? I'm setting the salary is 349. After that, begin transaction for the non-selective operations. The transaction is mandatory. That's why I'm beginning my transaction. Now I'm calling the execute update method on the query. Whenever you are calling the query.execute update method, the query will be executed, and whenever you are committing the transaction, the changes are reflected into the database. Finally, I'm closing the resources. This is about configuration file. Here nothing is there. We need to know how to create a SQL query and all those things. That's it only. No need to change the Hibernate. No need to change the configuration files. No need to change the mapping files and all those things. No need to change anywhere. Just wherever we are going to work, wherever we are going to update, that place only we are able to create a SQL query and all those things. That's it. I will show you whatever the data is available in employee. See, in my employee table, there is 6 records are available. Now I'm updating employee ID 1, the salary is 999. See, now after execution, my employee salary of employee 1 is updated with 349s. I will check with, I'm going to run as Java application. Now update employee set salary is equal to, now updated successfully. Now I'm going to check in my database, is it updated successfully or not. Now select star from employee. See, previously 100 is there for the employee 1. Now I'm updated with salary 499s. Now updated successfully. This is the way to work non-select operations on native SQL. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, Sada Learning Hub. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you subscribe this channel, then only we will get the updates. I'm going to create a updated technologies. Please subscribe our channel to get the latest updates. Thank you for watching.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel Sada Learning Hub, because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.